everybody, welcome to Active Self Protection Extra, here with my friend Adam Winch from Defenders USA, and I got a discussion for you today. We've been shooting stuff, you've seen videos that we've been doing and all that stuff, he's here in town, and I want to talk to you today why I think that the focus on your cold performance isn't really as important as some people think it is.
Everyone should have a less lethal tool on their person in this day and age, and the one that I carry, give to my family, and recommend to everyone is Palm OC. Hit the link in the description and you can get one for you and yours as well.
Mea culpa right up front. I'm not saying that you are, you know, gonna be your best on your very first iteration of the day. But you just said something to me off camera a second ago because we were talking about cold performance. And so many people go, the only thing that matters is your cold performance. The only thing that matters is the first thing that you do of the day. But I don't always find that to be the case, do you?
No, I mean, with a little bit of warm up, things oftentimes get better for me.
Sure.
I mean, enough to where I'm happy with it. But I've also found that at times when I just go in completely cold, no expectations, I just go run it. Sometimes I'm doing better than before. It's almost bipolar for me. Sometimes I get it when I'm doing really well and I'm warmed up, and other times completely cold is actually the very best time for me.
So here's what I find, and I agree with you. So that's when I think, so sometimes people go, only your cold performance matters. And why I think that that phrase has some validity to it is, you don't get no do-overs in gunfights,
no.
Right? So whatever you do on that one single iteration is what you do. So I get it from that perspective. But two things. Number one, I think my cold performance, if I have a ceiling of performance here and a floor here, right? So this is what I've trained to. Now, you know, and let's just say what it is what it is. Now you might say, well, wait a minute, I want that to be higher. I want it to be up here. I want my floor to come up. Well, that's what regular training does. It makes your floor higher and your ceiling higher so that you're up here rather than down here. If you don't train often, you don't practice often, you might have this skill up here, but your floor is going to go down here. So this is your available skills. I think your cold performance, I don't know where it's gonna be in this. It might be, I've had that too. We did this when we were in Spokane last February. We showed up, Neil and I were filming, we were doing some stuff, and the Mantis guys were there, so we were doing some Mantis stuff. I get on camera, we're doing 15 yard headshots. I'd shot no shots that day whatsoever. Shooter ready, standby, beep, bang, got a dead center hit, 1.48 seconds. Hmm. Put the gun back in the holster and said, I'm done, I'm not gonna do any better than that today. Right, so you go, oh, that's John's cold performance. No, that was a miracle. Quite frankly, that was my best day. But I was up here on that first shot. If I'd have done 20 iterations of that, I wouldn't have done better than that on that day. So you go, wait a minute, why does the cold performance matter then? What does matter, and this is something I got from Bill Blowers, okay? So Bill's the owner of Tap Rack Tactical, retired SWAT man, like a guy that I really respect. And Bill says, track your performance over time. Because you might say, gosh, man, my cold performance when I'm performing is somewhere in the middle often, and then I'll have better and I'll have worse. And then my goal is to push these up,
yes.
Right? Yeah. Is to continue to push these up. Not to put too much pressure on your cold performance, but to say, hey, I want my first iteration of the day and see where I am inside my window. And then work to push those up. Now, of course, the other part of this that I'm gonna say, you worked as a street cop for a number of years, for a decade or more. Did you just get up in the morning, throw your gear on and go to work, or did you maybe do a little bit of warm up and some dry fire?
So I was hoping you'd bring this up. Every time I went on duty, every time without fail, I got all my gear on and I ran through 10 dry fire reps, just 10, every time. When I took it off, when I went to take off the Batman suit, right, and all the gear, right, 10 dry fire reps. I would go home, right, when I'd strap on my concealed carry stuff as I was leaving for duty. When I'd go home, I'd go do 10 dry fire reps. The next day when I'm putting my Batman suit again, or at least my concealed carry stuff to go to work on, 10 dry fire reps. And it just became something to where, so though I might go into something cold, and I've had to pull guns in defensive life, right, after a couple hours of being cold in a sense, but I found that cold was highly enhanced by the dry fire reps on a continuous basis.
Or we would say you weren't really cold because you warmed up a little bit ago.
True.
You weren't truly cold, which is good.
You could say that. I mean, to me, if you're gonna strap a gun on, you should have all sorts of cold reps.
So even more. So I have a friend who works on San Diego PD.
Okay.
His name's Asa, incredible guy. I mean, just what I wish every cop was, right? Just an incredible dude. And there, the unit that he's working at, he gets 10 live fire rounds every day. Oh. And where their roll call is, they have a range right next to him.
Oh.
And so he's an FTO, and he'll have rookies, and he doesn't make them do them with him, but he'll give them prizes and stuff.
You're crazy if you don't.
And that's what I said. I was like, what moron would say, wait a minute, yes. I'm about to go out there, and the public might have a gunfight today, don't want to have a gunfight today, but I get to warm up? Like, why would I not do that today and just get better as we go? So the other part of why I think cold shots are misleading is because hopefully you're smart enough to do your dry fire every day. And you strap on and ready to go. And I do this every single day. I put on my gear, I put my gun on, I get my holster, I get all that stuff, unload and show clear, have a safe location in which to do that. Draw, click, got it, put the gun away. Click, got it, put the gun away. Click, click, click. Got it, put the gun away. Do just a basic dry fire presentation that takes me 60 seconds.
And it's important, I think, because we wear different clothing different days, right? And
right.
Especially if you're carrying concealed, whether it's appendix or side, pulling that shirt out of the way and getting onto it may be different shirt to shirt because of how you've got, right? If you've not considered your gear, your kit, the shirts you actually wear, right? If you've not thought it, I mean, some will be a little bit tighter, harder to get to. So it's not only important just for the trigger press, but it's also working through those clothing every day so you get the feel of what you're wearing that day.
Right now, today. Now I get it. If you wear formal clothes, your shirt's tucked in, those things, it's going to be difficult. But that's probably the days you need to do it most, probably more than anything. I also get it that you say, hey, that's kind of hard on my clothing, those kinds of things, you know, tucking it around and those things. So there can be some limits to that. But your cold performance shouldn't be that cold because you should have dry fired today. Number two, it's just somewhere in this range. So better than saying, well, your cold performance is the only one that matters, track your performance. Track your first iteration of the day, your second, your last iteration. I'll tell you what I tend to find when I'm like, if I'm taking a training class or even if I'm out here shooting, that I tend to run a bell curve, that I will be somewhere in my midst, and then as I work reps of something, I will get better. But if I do more, I will get worse again, because I start getting tired, my mind starts wandering and those kinds of things. So I'm not saying, you know, that's gonna always happen to you. All I'm saying today is, this guy knows what he's talking about, and as you train and as you work and as you do, track your cold performance, but don't look at it as the only one that matters.
Can I add to that?
Sure, fire away.
So you said you get cold or you get tired, things like that. I found for me too that as I shoot, if I'm having a slightly bad day, I start putting all sorts of internal pressure on myself, and then the wheels come off the bus.
They just do.
So you've got to calm it back down. And guess what? When you get yourself, if you ever get yourself in a gunfight, which is probably never going to happen, but if you do, right, the wheels are going to come off the bus. You've still got to be able to focus and concentrate in this. So when the wheels come off the bus, I look at it as kind of a gift where I can slow back down and reinforce myself to focus on the fundamentals. Because if I do get myself into something, well, I've got to be able to think that way too.
Process focus. Focus, right? Yeah. Process focus. And so there's the last part, is that when I see this target or whatever, sometimes this makes me outcome focused, right? That this makes me focused on what did my outcome happen. But true improvement only happens when I'm process focused. Okay. When I say, nope, this is the process I go through to do that, whether I'm in a gunfight or I'm out at the range. So yes, cold performance is not nothing, but it ain't everything.